it's a unique sporting experience. You know, a lot of people are like, what's a festival of sport? And I'm like, well, a festival of sports like a music festival, but it's just our stages are sports. I'm Helen Stumbos. I am the founder and CEO of The Good Games, and we are right here in Guelph, Ontario at the University of Guelph, where we host The Good Games.
My name is Mike Jean. I'm one of the team members of The Good Games. You know, The Good Games started as a Masters multi-sport tournament. You know, there were these stats that we were reading that said, you know, most sports fall off after high school and university. And we were watching these kind of like masters movements kind of pop up where you had athletes, you know, 30 plus, 40 plus, 50 plus kind of getting into these multi-sport tournaments and kind of really having a good time. It was almost like an Olympics for regular people.
I always loved playing in tournaments when I was a kid. And then I think when I was in my 40s, I started playing beach volleyball after my soccer career. And I realized I went into a tournament and I was like, oh, that was so much fun. Like, it was so fun to play with your team and, you know, hang out for the whole weekend. And I just thought, gosh, I really missed that experience. And we started talking about bringing a sporting event here to Guelph.
The University of Guelph hosts some of the best facilities in Canada. And the way the grounds are situated, we have our festival zone and our tournaments all within walking distance of each other.
The whole thing is built basically around, like, as an athlete that's, you know, participated with teams, that loves playing sport, that loves tournaments, and thought, you know what, they don't have enough of these for adults, so how do we create something?
So if you're coming to The Good Games, everything is close and within walking distance. You don't have to drive anywhere. We have free parking on site. The event is free for families. So you show up and you're able to see everything if you spend a good amount of time here.
That's the part of this event that's a bit more unique, is everything's so condensed and in a tight quarters, and you can play your sport and be part of a big festival experience. Usually multi-sport games, you drive a long way to go between A and B, or beach volleyball and soccer, and then the festival somewhere else, or the, you know, the evening event festivities are somewhere else. But the cool thing about this event is it's all here. When creating this, that was a big part of it. How do we make it so people aren't traveling everywhere and they can feel like they're in Olympic Games? They're probably the best sports facilities in the country. I don't know if you can find better facilities than this. I've been hearing from a lot of our athletes at how excited and happy they are with the quality of the facilities here. And just the proximity of where everything is. It's so close together. I mean, women's soccer and walking soccer and slow pitch and beach volleyball and pickleball, and everything's just in this 1 kilometer radius. And I think that's why Guelph is perfect.
Oh, man. Oh. First of all, my name is Quincy Mack, a.k.a. QMack, NBA All-Star Entertainer and professional event host. You know, I've been very proud to be a part of such a world-class and up-and-coming event, as I told Helen and Mike today. Every year when I walk in, I'm impressed with the trajectory, the new events and sponsors, partners, and activations that I see. I've always had such a good time in the Royal City. I'm always happy to be back.
There's two parts of the games. There's the athlete competition. Those are for adult athletes, so anybody over 20. Some categories are over 50, 65, over 70.
The thing that's interesting about our team is that over half our team is over 75. And I'm here with my women's soccer team to play in the over 70 soccer division. We're always looking for new tournaments to go to. And this one, as soon as we saw it, we knew we wanted to go. We interact with soccer players in all age divisions, and especially having everything in one place like this tournament does, that's really attractive because we get to talk to the spectators as well as the players and just meet new people.
My name's Ashlyn Cairns. I live in Guelph, and I was really excited to see that the Good Games had a 5K trail race. And that they had a non-binary category. So I am always looking for inclusive trail races, and this one was absolutely awesome.
Last year we came and we got a silver medal, so we needed to come back to win that gold.
We just had such a great time last year with the organizers, and they're so attentive to the athletes' needs. It's just such a great environment over here. The family, the music, the food, it's just, there's no choice really. really about to come back.
You better remember this face and this face, because 2025, we're bringing back gold.
Let's go, baby.
Then there's the other part, that's the festival. You know, we originally created the festival to be entertainment for the athletes. And then last year when we ran the games, we noticed that there were a lot of people coming that just wanted to experience the festival.
I think having a multi-sport games brings so much more of the community together. There's so much going on here. I'm looking around, there's like jump roping, arm wrestling. There's like a kids zone, which my kids have been thrilled about, because although they like to cheer me on, they don't really love to sit there and watch me. So it's amazing to have them here and experience everything.
We had 2 or 3 hours between games, so we come down, walk around, you know, run into people we know, chat. It's just nice. It's different.
We're Canada's largest festival of sport, and the atmosphere here is just, it's electric, it's on fire. We have community members who come and actually watch the athletes and cheer them on, and that's kind of a little unique take to the typical sport tournament for these athletes. I think a festival goer coming to the good games can expect to have the time of their lives. It's a celebration of sport. What we're trying to really do is we're trying to get people to witness the transformational power of sport. And we do that by having them watch sports, play sports, and then learn different kind of activations.
We got an activation happening at 11 o'clock where we get the public running out and put some rugby balls in the hands of some adults and some kids, and hopefully there'll be big smiles to go along with it. We're going to be running some passing drills and some stepping drills, and maybe get a game of tag going, have some kids smashing into some tackle pads with their big smiles. It'll be a lot of fun.
We're here to spread the word of dodgeball. Like, obviously you're throwing balls, that's a lot of fun, but for me, mostly community, all the people I've met and all the countries I've been able to visit.
I'm Nadia, and this is Perpetual Motion Sports. So we're a recreational sports league in Guelph for adults.
We want to spread this, you know, cricket across the, you know, kids. Yeah, we are just giving it an opportunity for free play, like how to hold the bat, how does that different from a baseball. So if they are interested, they can join our kids coaching.
We want people to, let's say, be in their 20s and where sports has possibly fallen off, and we want them to get excited and motivated and get right back into sport, which has happened. And we want little kids to never let it go, to have this be just a part of growing up, but just a part of who they are.
About the festival that was really important to us is making sure it was free to attend. I think that sport heals, transforms, unites, and I never wanted money to be a barrier for any family to be able to come here. So I think that was a really big thing for us, is to make sure we could, you know, bring enough partners together to support a festival where families could come, bring their kids and not have to pay for it. And I just think sport, it's unfortunate sports become something that people can't afford anymore. You know, I look at myself and I think, I just started by kicking a ball around in my backyard and it took me to the World Cup. So I'm like, when we give kids experiences, or families or adults experiences to try something new or to see something new, like, who knows if it might ignite something in them to try it as well. Are you guys having a good time? Good, good. Have you made out to the festival yet?
So one of our strategies has always been to have sports that are part of our tournament but are also really good to look at. So sports like, beach volleyball.
Beach volleyball is I call it our main stage, or our, one of our main sports.
Well, we're here at our main stage. It's beach volleyball. It's our main stage for a reason.
Because we tend to attract a lot of really good volleyball talent, you know, that have played in Olympic games and have former national team members.
To be honest, that's one of the reasons we created the games, where you have pro athletes who are done playing, but still have that spirit inside them. They still have that drive. We have regular people who still have the drive from high school and university. They stop playing, and now they're competing against each other.
There's not a lot of tournaments like the good games, because for us, as we're getting older athletes, we'll play in some local events, but there's no big organization. So it feels good to come back on a center court, having the music, having the fans. It really brings you back to the golden days of when you were a superstar athlete.
I used to play professionally and I have recently retired, but the good games brought me here to step out of retirement for a couple days. This is an amazing grassroots event, multi-sport. It kind of feels like a mini Olympics. And it's amazing to see the community come together for all kinds of sport and cheer each other on and get a good sense of like professionalism.
Helen and I are so thankful for you guys to come out. We love the running community, even though I hate running. But you guys are long distance anyway. I'm more of a sprint guy. But I'm going to be running next year, so I'm joining the community. And I said, I got to run in the 5K. I love you guys.
We have women's soccer. I think the cool thing about women's soccer, our age categories are over 50, over 65, and over 70. I mean, I have 81-year-olds coming to play in women's soccer. We have walking soccer, which is very unique and new to this area. It's very popular in Europe. We have cornhole, which is, you know, a non-traditional sport that you would bring to a multi-sport games, but I wanted that. Like, I wanted to include maybe other sports that don't traditionally go in multi-sport games, which I love.
We have rugby, slow pitch, disc golf, arm wrestling. We have 3v3 basketball. We have pickleball.
One of our highlights this year, we were the biggest amateur pickleball tournament in Ontario to date. Then we also have the pickleball pros. So the best pickleballers in Canada are playing as part of our event as well.
We have the Freestyle Soccer Championships here every year, and that is a big crowd favorite. Watching those guys do some of those tricks with those balls is insane.
Our Freestyle Soccer Championships is a competition, but it's also an event because I think people really love watching freestyle soccer. Tech ball is a competition, but it's also an event, and I think that's a fun one. A lot of interest in that one. We had rope skipping this year that came in doing some showcases.
I mean, rope skipping just sounds like rope skipping, but when you see some of the tricks that these guys are doing, rope skipping while doing handstands, rope skipping while doing burpees, it's something really, really fun to watch, and then it gets people wanting to try those sports.
We have an iron dog showcase. We wanted to include everybody, and I think furry friends are part of us, you know, being active and healthy. And I always wanted to include something with dogs, and so we brought the iron dog in. And of course, we can't forget the Indigenous Sport and Wellness Council of Ontario. They're here running a number of Indigenous activations and cultural activations, which I absolutely love, because I'm a big believer that sport unites, and this is the best way to bring people together is sport.
Sport is very important. It helps people have a sense of belonging. And we like to say movement is medicine, so we like to encourage people of all ages to continue with sport. It brings people together, and I find that even as an athlete or as a spectator, it brings people together. We're bringing lacrosse to the Good Games, giving the demonstration. But lacrosse is really big in our communities, right? Where we lack is giving that new opportunity for something like pickleball or for, you know, futsal or those kind of things. It's really important to be able to introduce new games to the adults in our communities. And I think that, like, coming here is very inspiring because I want to go back to my community and say, hey, let's play pickleball.
I like the uniqueness of it and just the name itself, the Good Game, right? Like, you think about sport, what it does for people, and that really it does good. Like, that's what it is. It's about maintaining that active for life philosophy.
We have two stats that kind of fuel our main goal. So one was that sports usually falls off after university or high school. And the other one was that 95% of adults over the age of 30 will never sprint again ever in their lives. So these are two things that we said, we've got to be able to do something about that. And the Good Games is unique because it bridges the gap, if you will. So you have kids of all ages, and then you have athletes as old as 90 years old. And to be honest, that's what we do it for. So we want the games to be an introduction to a lifestyle.
The lifestyle of sport for adults is so important for not just building my own personal health, but building community.
The grassroots nature of walking soccer and the camaraderie, you know, it's the social side of walking soccer is almost as important as the physical side. I mean, the benefits, the mental health benefits and the physical benefits are enormous.
Having sport in your life is just so good for fitness. I mean, I personally don't like going to the gym working out. Beach volleyball is my workout. It's so fun. And also just mentally, just to put your life aside for an hour or two and play, I find it so good for my mental health and just going back to focusing on myself, and it cheers me up. So I think it would be good for everybody to just sort of get involved in some organized sport.
I think it makes a big difference for your mentality because you're more alert. You meet a variety of people, you do different things, yes. It's fun. It's so much fun.
Games!
Here we go.
This is Party Centralized here. 12 sports, 2 days, one big party. We got the beer tent, we got Domino's, we got Harvey's, we've got the family festival, the activity zone. There's kids with face paint, the balloon animals. There's something for everybody here at the University of Guelph 2024 Good Games.
We have a lot of long-term plans for the games. We want to introduce more of these unique sports. We want more people here. We want to do a lot more education on how people can participate, how people can actually go from sedentary to being part of the games.
I want people from around the world to come to the Good Games and participate or come watch, or, I mean, much like the Stampede, you know, if we can become something like that where we have a great festival, we have great sport experiences for the athletes, you know, I don't like saying what it's going to be because I'll let it just unfold like it's supposed to.
Like anything, there are a lot of growing pains, but the growing pains are also learning pains. And so we're learning what works, what didn't work. We're learning what we could have made bigger. We're learning what we could have made better. And some of the things that we didn't have, that we wanted to have, and we're like, I would have been perfect. We should have had it. So we're going to make sure to include them for next year.
The only way this event happens is with a freaking amazing team.
You got some wonderful volunteers doing their volunteer thing.
We've all been volunteers in this since the beginning, and then the volunteers themselves. Like, this event cannot run without the support of like an amazing group. Like, we have this core group of volunteers. We've been together since 2019 trying to execute these games, and most of our team has stayed together even through COVID, where we got detoured, and we've stuck with it. We've met constantly. We've been part of it. So I think from a team perspective, we're so proud of the fact that, you know, we stuck through all those difficult times to finally execute what we had envisioned from the beginning. And then I think from a volunteer perspective, I think we had over 150 volunteers come out. And I mean, events like this don't run without our volunteers. It's absolutely impossible. So we're very lucky. And I have to say, University of Guelph, I mean, their support staff here, how many fires they helped us blow out this year was insane. And they go above and beyond. I think that's what makes this event here awesome. The staff here are unbelievable. They're a partner. I don't even consider them, you know, a facility we're running it at. The university is a partner, and they treat us as a partner, and they treat the event like they're running it themselves. You know, the competitions went great. The festival was amazing. People had fun.
The athletes had fun, which is our number one goal. If the athletes have fun and if the athletes show up, then that's great. You know, we more than doubled our athlete count from a little over 400 athletes last year to over 1,200 athletes this year, and we're looking to increase that again.
We executed a great event with great competitions. Whether you're competing as an athlete or whether you're coming as a festival goer, you're gonna have a great time because we have so many opportunities for you to just, different experiences you can have that I don't think are anywhere else.
So we're inviting you to come down to the Good Games. You stayed home this year, come down next year.
Come out, come have fun, come enjoy, bring your family, bring your kids, come compete, have a great time.
Doesn't matter if you're from Guelph, we've had people from Hawaii, from Brazil, we've had athletes from all over North America driving, flying in. Doesn't matter if you take a train, if you take a cruise ship, grab a helicopter, get yourself an Uber. You need to be at the Good Games 2025 edition. If you're not there, you're nowhere. Trust me, get yourself a ticket. Oh, did I mention admission is free?
You're gonna have a blast, whether you're coming here to watch, whether you're coming here to play, whether you're coming here to learn, you're gonna have a good time, guaranteed.
We'll see you in 2025.